the ever charming, ever professional Mark Elias, director of sales at the Little Nell in Aspen, and discover how a not so normal ski resort plans to deliver the most normal ski vacation experience in North America as 2021 ski season approaches, and learn why normal at the Little Nell in Aspen is anything but.
So, Mark, it is a pleasure to have you here. I am a huge, huge fan, not only of the Little Nell, but of Aspen. And you know all this, so this is no news to you. And I'm excited to have you share with us a little bit about the new normal. But as you know, you mentioned it, the Little Nell and Aspen is not a place that would fall within the normal topic, right? You would never think about a normal experience. And yet now, people are kind of looking for a normal. So give us a little bit of an insight. What is Aspen and what is the Little Nell as of now? What can people look forward to?
Yeah, you know, that word normal. First of all, Tina, thank you for keeping the industry together and for doing everything you're doing with TL Talks and Rep Fest. It's amazing. And thank you for having us be a part of it. It's incredible. So I just wanted to take a minute and say thank you. As far as what we're doing here at the Nell, you know, I'll rewind the clock a couple of weeks. You know, as we started winding down summer, the hotel's actually closed right now, and we're starting to look forward to winter, and it's a little bit unprecedented. And I thought, how are we selling this winter? And we've had meetings, you know, towards the end of the summer, what winter is going to look like. And we've been sort of waiting to hear the message from the Aspen Skiing Company and from the state of Colorado on what skiing is going to look like. What can the ski areas do? How many people can we have on the mountain? What are these restrictions? And it's never very clear. And so as things started becoming a little bit more clear, and it's still a bit unclear, we had a meeting with one of our executives from the Aspen Skiing Company, and he was telling us all the measures that they're taking. And, you know, so I raised my hand and I said, so I have a sales team that is talking to people, and we're just not sure what the message is. I know what we've been telling everybody, and I want to make sure that it's correct. And I said, you know, our message is we want to be as normal as we possibly can. And they said, bingo, you got it. We don't want the experience in Aspen this year to feel any different than any other year. We want people to feel comfortable. We want people to come and enjoy their vacations, of course. And we want it to feel as normal as it can feel, given the restrictions, that we'll be under. So I went back to my sales team and I said, okay, here's the message. Normal's the message. And part of this came from, we saw as the other ski areas were very early in announcing what they were going to do. They weren't going to have lift ticket offices open for people to walk up and buy a ticket on the same day. They were going to restrict certain passes on certain days. You could only ski on the mountain if you made a reservation. Some of the food and beverage options would be extraordinarily limited on other ski areas. And we didn't want to do any of that. And Aspen Skiing Company wisely sat back and saw what the other resorts were doing and said, we don't want to do that. Our guests deserve better. Our guests want it to be as normal as possible. So we're going to keep it as normal as possible. And so we'll talk about some of the things we're going to do to keep it normal in a minute. But a couple of days went by, and I think I was on a hike and I was up at the top of Smuggler Mountain, and you can see the colors behind me. It's just beautiful here right now. And we're towards the end of fall. And I'm looking down on town and I'm thinking, normal. There's nothing normal about this experience. There's nothing normal about this hotel or about Aspen as a resort. It's exceptional. It's anything but normal. And so I think we have to adjust our message a little bit to be the special, and I know it's a cliche word, but the special experience that our guests have and come back for year after year, we want to keep that going and we want to keep that as normal as possible. We don't want to take that away from them. So we're going to continue to deliver the abnormal in as normal a fashion as we possibly can.
And it's exactly what you said. I mean, looking at your background, it could be a virtual background. It's that mind-boggling beautiful. And you just happen to be sitting in the porch, you know? That's the reality of it. And there's nothing normal about it. And it's interesting, as you said, right now, people aim for normality. And that's never been a goal. Nobody wants to be normal, right? You want to be extraordinary. And that's what Little Nell and Aspen are. It's extraordinary. And so it is a kind of a, it's a conundrum, because it's like, oh, I just want normal. It's like, no, you don't. You know, you want amazing. You want extraordinary. And I have no doubt that that's exactly what you guys are going to pull together and make it happen. So tell us a little bit about, you know, what the experience is going to be. Are there going to be, when you, is there any change, potentially less people on the lifts, or can you really just imagine, you know, can I book my favorite experience? I have to share this because I am not a crybaby. I'm a pretty tough cookie. But when I went with you on that first cat on powder, and I had never skied powder, I felt like I was flying, and I cried, and I kept saying, I don't usually cry, but I was flying. That was amazing. And I look forward to that every year. It's my, you know, and I love the fact that we do it together, and you know, it's fun. It's adrenaline. It's all of that. Is that going to happen? Can I look forward to that? How does that look?
You can look forward to that, Tina, and we'll make sure we get you on one of the cats, and yes, I'll be on it. This is the sacrifice we make for our guests. I will leave the office and go ski in the backcountry with you. No worries there. I think we actually have, I sent some footage down of what the powder tour looks like, but no video is ever going to do it justice. It truly is an experience that you have to come indulge in to truly understand it. It's for intermediate skiers. And I think this year, you know, so let's talk about some of the changes, because the cat tours are going to change a little bit. And in years past, the Little Nell, how this all started was, for those who aren't familiar with what the powder tour is, it's on the backside of Aspen Mountain, there's about 1,200 ungroomed acres of skiing. Contrast that to the front side, where there's about 675. And so there's about three cats a day that go on the backside of Aspen Mountain, and you don't see the other two. You're basically with yourself and 10 colleagues and a couple of guides and a couple of us from the hotel. And we take you on the backside of Aspen Mountain to ski untracked powder all day. You don't hear any other crowds. You're not with any other people. All you hear is people laughing and falling and you know, having a great time, and they're in waist-deep powder. It's a very, very special experience. It is going to change a little bit this year. Number one, I think it's going to be in higher demand this year. What we used to do at the Little Nell, because this adventure was so popular, it started about 5 years ago. We would buy one cat every Friday, because what would happen is our guests would come into the hotel and they weren't able to get a seat on any of the cats because they were always sold out. So we thought ahead about 5 years ago and thought, well, let's buy the cat on Friday and see if we can fill it. Well, that became an instant hit and was incredibly popular and filled every single Friday. So the second year it ran, we bought it on Wednesdays and Fridays. So we had 2 days a week that we were taking our guests out in the backcountry for this amazing, you know, powder tour experience. And what we would do is we would cobble together different groups of our guests. So I know a lot of our guests. I've been here at the Little Nell for a long time, and we get a couple that would come in, and I know they're keen skiers, and I'd say, hey, I've got two seats for you on the cat if you want to go. And of course, they, you know, anytime I would call somebody, they'd go, give me 2 seconds. I'll call you right back and I'll let you know. And it would always fill up that way. So I was able to just sort of cherry pick from some of our guests and some of our owners at the residences and people that were staying with us for seats on the cat. Well, this year it's a little bit different, right? Because we can't put groups of strangers together. So what we've seen now is that the demand for the cats increase because people can only book it by themselves as a group, an entire cat together. We can't put different groups of strangers on it. So the demand will be increased, but the adventure is still going to be there. We're still going to ski, and I'm still going to go with you. And we're forecasting a great winter snow-wise, according to all the Farmer's Almanac and aspenweather.net. And so it should be an exceptional year, and we're looking forward to getting some ski.
And just to highlight, you know, going on the cat and going on the cat with a Little Nell are two completely different experiences. I mean, from the goodies on the cat to having you guys and to the treat at the end of the day, it's a lunch, the cabin, it's just so, so amazing. I mean, I'm not going to say it all, because if you've never done it, there's a bunch of surprises along the way, and it's something to look forward to. And what I do every year, I'm not great at it, but as you said, we have a ball, we fall, we, you know, thank God. It's the beauty of going on a cat with the Little Nell is that somebody picks you up, because otherwise falling on that amount of powder is not easy to get up. But there you go, you can fall, you can laugh, and 3 seconds later there's Mark, phew, picks you up, and there we go again. It's it's a dream, really is. And how about Aspen? What is the experience like? What's new? What does it feel like right now? Because it looks stunning. And I'm sure, you know, obviously that doesn't change. The stores, the coffees, the people, what's the vibe?
Yeah, so, well, it is beautiful here right now. This is not a fake background, and forgive my squinting. It's a little bit blinding out here right now, which is okay. But, you know, in terms of what's going to look different on the mountain, well, we have some things that are normally different every year, some upgrades. They're doing, for the first time ever, we have snowmaking from the top of Aspen Mountain to the bottom of Aspen Mountain, and that should ensure us an on-time opening. Now, look, I have to say that with a grain of salt, because some of the biggest powder days I've ever had were on days when we actually opened for the season early, because we just had huge snowstorms in November. We hope that's the case this year, but who knows what Mother Nature is going to bring. So with the snowmaking top to bottom on Aspen Mountain, it's a big innovation for us. And that's something that we expected to do regardless of COVID. Fortunately, they didn't put the brakes on that, and that's happening. So we should open on time, which will be Thanksgiving this year. So that's some of the normal things that would be happening. Normal, our favorite word. And then in order to ensure that our guests do feel normal, we're taking some unusual measures to make sure that the mountains are running effectively this year. So the first one, I think, is number one, we're not restricting any capacity, at least not for the moment. Aspen's not crowded. That's one of the great things about skiing here in Aspen. Everyone skiing on Aspen Mountain, on Snowmass, on Buttermilk, on Aspen Highlands is staying in the Aspen Snowmass Resort Complex. So we don't get a lot of day skiers from any big cities, unlike the resorts near Denver, near Salt Lake. So it's never crowded here. So we don't have to put restrictions on reservations, at least not yet. Things are evolving, but we hope not to have to do that, which is a good thing, right? One of the restrictions that we do have, however, is on our restaurants and on dining inside and on, you know, social distancing. So the skiing company has been extremely proactive in ensuring that all of our guests can go out and enjoy the mountain. I think skiing is obviously a socially distant experience, right? A socially distant sport. But when you go in to dine, that's not always the case. And one of the things that's changing for us from summer to winter, it's a little bit more difficult to dine outside in the winter when it's colder, right? So that's what the skiing company has been very proactive. They've bought a number of tents that they're going to position outside of all of their restaurants that can seat up to 60 people. So this will be right here at the sun deck at the top of Aspen Mountain. When we hit that capacity of people inside the sun deck, the tent can open up. People can dine in the tent, be in the tent to warm up, et cetera. They've also bought several hundred picnic tables to spread out across all four mountains so people can dine outside. And that'll give the people, you know, our guests an opportunity to be outside with their colleagues, with their friends, and not go, where are we going to eat? There's nowhere to go. It's full.
Yeah.
And then one of the other things that I'm pretty excited about, for those who are familiar with Aspen, we're actually going to reopen Ruthie's, which is one of the restaurants here on Aspen Mountain right at the base of Ruthie's Lift. Won't be serving food, but it will be an area that people can take some grab and goes, which are also going to be positioned all across all four mountains. We're sort of doing a market style grab and go for skiers so they can come by, grab some food, head to a picnic table, be able to dine and still be able to have a great experience. Even though when it's in the winter, as you can see, Aspen is very, very sunny. So people do like to dine outside regardless of what month it is, even in December and January. So the mountain's done a nice job of innovating and making sure that we can accommodate all of our guests, spread the crowds out appropriately, and kudos to them. They've done an amazing job at making sure the ski experience is going to remain abnormally amazing.
One of the things that I think is so interesting also, not only about the destination, but about the Little Nell as a team, as leadership, is that you guys have a very united team. You've gone through the same ups and downs as everybody in the industry. You've had a busy summer, I know. I mean, it's, you know, if anybody had a choice of where to go, you know, Aspen and the Little Nell was top of the list. And I know a lot of people enjoyed it. However, tell us a little bit about how the Little Nell, you know, looked at this pandemic, because the team is there, you're all positive, you're all very, you know, gung-ho. It hasn't, it's, you, that energy hasn't changed. And I, it's very admirable. And I can feel it from a distance. You know, we had Alinio in a TL talk, which was fantastic. His, you know, his upbeat and his vision is incredible. But how have you kept that energy so alive, despite everything going on?
Yeah, it's the people. Right. I mean, one of the things that we don't talk about enough are the people here. And, you know, Tina, on one of your TL talks, and actually on a few of them, the idea of a host kept coming up over and over and over again, and seeing a familiar face. And particularly for our travel professionals that are sending people here, they want to know that they have somebody here that's on property that they can trust. And so whether it's our sales team or, I mean, the guys in the ski concierge, some of them have been here since the early 90s. We don't have a lot of turnover here, and people really take pride in their careers here at the Little Nell and here in Aspen. So I think the people, this hotel apart, the preparation that went into reopening this hotel this summer, and I'm sure this is not unique to us. I think every hotel did this, but I know from some of my colleagues who traveled and then stayed here, and I'm humbled to say this, but they said nobody did it as well. So it was from when you got picked up at the airport and our car showed up and knew that it was cleaned electro with an electrostatic fogger prior to you getting in the car. And then there's a plexiglass separator between you and the driver. And then you got to the hotel and it's a keyless check-in. And we have, you know, everybody did the QR codes on the tables. We did those as well. All the measures we took this summer to reopen the hotel. And now we're having to redo it for winter all over again, and figured out what that looks like. But I think we take a lot of pride in the product. It's a Forbes 5-star award winner. Has been for a long, long time, since the mid-90s. And the team and the staff here take a lot of pride in delivering this product. And we didn't want to compromise on it. We want the product to be exceptional, as it always is, which is sort of the theme of this conversation, that everything remains, quote unquote, normal.
No, and I couldn't agree with you more. I mean, I think about, you know, my trip at the end of the year. And of course, I think about the ski and I think about the property and all that. But you're right. You know, I think about you and Pete and all the guys and getting together. And it's like going home to see friends. You know, if somebody says you can't go, I'm going to be like a hole in my calendar to hang, you know, and to have fun. And it's part of that experience. And that's very, very unique. There is an experience that I'm especially passionate about that blew me away, which is that cellar, which is completely out of, you know, it's kind of not what you expect. And it's so surprising. Are these things going to change? Is there novelty? Can you talk about it? How, you know, can we expect some new surprises?
Yeah, Tina, did you ask about the wine cellar? I'm sorry, the gondola is running. I'm having a hard time here. Okay.
I did.
Okay, yeah. Yeah, I think, look, people come to Aspen to ski in the winter. And one of the other things that our guests come to the Little Nell for, part of the rooms are spectacular and the service and the regular people, but our wine program is definitely an enormous part of our DNA and the experience here in Aspen. And so we're having to adjust that a little bit and evolve a little bit. So, you know, throughout the summer, we realized we weren't able to bring people down to the cellar, which was a huge hit for us. Our wine program and our wine cellar here is an incredible experience. And you know this because you've been, but I'll walk the people through who haven't. Chances are you would be meeting me or Pete or one of somebody on our team in the living room, and we would walk you through the back of house, and you'd go, where are we? We're going through the kitchen, and then we would go down through the stairs and then into the garage, and people go, are you sure you're taking us somewhere really special? And then we would turn the corner, and all of a sudden you end up in our cellar, this red light lounge, which has 22,000 bottles, an award-winning wine selection. We've got bottles of wine down there that are over 150 years old. It's an incredible experience, but it's very, very small. So with the social distancing restrictions and the restrictions on groups, unfortunately, we had to shut the cellar down this summer. We don't want to shut it down this winter. So we are evolving the wine program as we do typically on an annual basis. But we are looking at some spaces throughout the hotel to relocate the wine cellar that will allow us to give us the opportunity to have social distancing, but still meet with our incredible wine team and our very knowledgeable